Hey everyone, welcome back to this week's Tuesday Tip, and in this week's video we're going to be talking about what I think is the best and most easy to use video editor for iPhone, and that is Splice. Splice is a video editor I've used for probably 3 years now, ever since Instagram took out the ability to edit clips in the app. And even since they've added that again, I still use this because I think it's the most easy to use and precise video editor out there. So let's open the app and get started. So when you first open the app after downloading it, this is what you're going to see, other than maybe a tutorial screen. But right here, we're going to start a new project. And here you get to pick video. You can pick from your albums on your phone. I usually favorite the clips I want to use, so let's pick this one of Danny, this one of Brian, and how about this 28 second one here. Then you click add. If you want to add music, you can add music. There's already music in the app, and then you can access your iTunes. And you can pick songs from your phone as well. I don't normally do this, but you can if you want to. Then from here you have all of these settings to choose from. You can pick your default transition, which I always set to none. You can pick how long the transition lasts if you want a transition. You can pick how long a photo will last on the timeline if you have photos. You can have an outro, and you can have the photo motion Ken Burns effect if you have photos in here. Click done. And now comes the easy part, and this is why I like this app so much. All you have to do to edit video is click on it, click edit video, and immediately it brings you a trim screen. So you can pick here, and if you look closely right above this blue line here, you can see that it has precise timing on it. So you can pick exactly the point in time when you want to cut it. So we'll pick here, and then we'll pick right about there. Looks good. And the cool thing too is that you can add filters to the video. You can adjust time so you can slow things down and speed things up. You can add text. You can zoom in or out or make a Ken Burns motion effect. And you can change the audio on it to make it fade in or fade out. So what's cool about the numbers up here is that if you want to slow things down or speed things up, you have to do multiple clips. So these numbers tell you exactly where your clip picks up or leaves off, so you can line it up with the exact frame that you need to on the clip that you have to slow down or speed up. To do that, we go back to the edit screen, duplicate the video, edit the video, and we bring the beginning point to where we want to slow down or speed up. So I'm going to bring it to right at 6.0. Then we change the end to where we want the slow motion or fast motion to stop. We'll make it 6.6. So now we go back, we duplicate again. And to move things around on your timeline, all you have to do is click and hold and then drag it to where you want it. So right here, we'll bring it in and we'll edit the end of this one to be right at 6.0, because that's where we started our slow motion, which is what we're going to do. 6.0, go back. Then we change the beginning of our end clip to 6.6. Go back. And now we have the middle clip here, which is our slow motion. We go in here and we slow it down by sliding it to the left, or speed it up by sliding it to the right. To the right you get twice as fast, and to the left you get 2/10 as fast. Go back. And we can watch it. So you can see that's pretty cool there. All right, so now that we've edited that one, we'll go in and edit the clip of Brian where we want it to start and stop. Start it and we'll stop it right there. Oh, we've got another clip. Okay. We'll do this one right here. And we'll stop it right after he falls and hurts his ankle. Right there. And since that was the trick he was trying that he landed in the previous clip, we'll move it to right before. So now we have a completed project and we can preview it. Okay, so as you saw, that ended kind of abruptly. So what I'm going to do is bring the clips of Brian to before the clip of Danny. And sometimes it's a little bit finicky and you have to do it more than once to get things rearranged the way you wanted to, but it's not really a big deal. There we go. Let's preview that. One more thing that I forgot to point out is that to add transitions, all you have to do is click the little box between videos here and you can add a transition and you can adjust how long the transition lasts. So we're going to add a crossfade in here. We're going to make it a half second. And if we come back to the beginning and play it, you'll see it fades into the next clip. So now let's take a look at the audio panel. So as you can see here, you can add voiceover with this microphone, you can add two tracks of audio, and you can click and you can edit the audio from your original video. I'm not going to add any audio, so now that the video is done, all we have to do is click the share button up here, and you can copy a link, share it in messages, email, upload it directly to YouTube, Facebook, or Instagram. Normally what I do is I just save it, click HD 1080p, so that it's the highest quality possible, and it just saves for you. Now that that's finished, you should be able to just come out, go into your camera roll, and it should be the last thing in your camera roll. There it is. Yeah. And there we go, now you have a completed video. So, going back into Splice, as you can see, it's a pretty simple app that's very easy to use and easy to navigate around, and that's why I like it so much. So this is what I think is the best video editing app for iPhone. I'm not sure if it's on Android, I don't think it is, but I hope you guys enjoyed and thanks for watching. We're going to get to the giveaway winner right now. Alright, now that we've gone over the app, I'm going to pick last week's giveaway winner. So I've got the video open here, we're going to copy the link. Go to our random comment picker, load the comments. Right here, it says we've got 25 unique users. We're gonna randomly pick the winner. And, okay, apparently I win. No, we're gonna pick again. And Nick Meta. All right, Nick, if you see this, please leave a comment with your Instagram name and I'll try to find you on there. So hopefully we can get this out to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll probably do another giveaway next week. So we'll see you then. Bye.